sense of separation. The idea of an individual, a person, a separate entity. And nobody ever tells us, listen, you were never separate in the first place. So the belief is taken on that we are separate entities, we are persons, we are individuals. And the belief is not the actual. Have a look and see how many beliefs you've got. And see that a belief can never be the actual. And the definition in the dictionary of a belief is an unquestioned acceptance of something in the absence of reason. Acceptance of an alleged fact without positive knowledge or proof. So if you've got these beliefs, they won't stand up to investigation. Facts you're absolutely certain of, which is the actual, is the fact of your own being. There's nobody who can say, I am not. You don't believe you are. There's nobody who believes I am. You know. If you believe that you are, like I say, come on and say you're not. You're not there at all. You might believe that, didn't you? But you could never believe that because you actually know that you are. It's that knowingness. There's always and ever that near. We can't do much with I am. The little child can't do much with that I thought, that I am thought. So what do we do with it? To make it seem insubstantial and some give it some reality, we add to the defence, experiences and conditioning. We're added on to that I thought. I'm Bob, I'm Australian. I'm a good fella, I'm not so good. If it's low self-esteem or something happened to my childhood and I feel insufficient or not complete, or I'm unhappy or resentful, or I've got a bad, angry nature, all these concepts are added on to that I thought. And we've built a mental picture of what we believe ourselves to be, a conceptual image. And that conceptual image, energy of belief constantly going in it, makes it seemingly substantial and solid, makes it feel like an entity. Anybody that's never looked at this and say that, you know, have a look at this eye and say, yeah, this is me, this is I. If you go into it closely enough and see what you're referring to, you'll find that you can't find a me or an I there that has any substance or any independent nature really. It's just a group of concepts you've got. And that group of concepts is what we call the self-centered or the ego. And you're told in a lot of the things that your ego is your problem. You've got to sublimate it, you've got to destroy it, you've got to do this and that with it. And that becomes the reference point, that self-centered or ego. And everything is relative to that. All their problems of relationship with it, relative to. Relative to what I think or what I believe or what I see or hear and translate. And all their problems are relationship. Because relationship is dualism, relative to. It's me and the other. And we're talking about, remember again, never forget it, it's non-duality. Running out of spine without a second, there is only that. There's always and only and ever been that. And there can be absolutely no duality in non-duality. If there was, it wouldn't be non-duality. But we've created and believed in all this dualism. And as I say, the minute appearance, the manifestation is appearing as dualism. That's why it is not the reality. It's the way it appears. And it couldn't appear any other way. There would be any appearance if there wasn't, day couldn't be without night. Silence couldn't be without sound. Movement couldn't be without stillness. Past, future, all the rest of it, it's all appearance must rely on its opposite to appear. So they are both a fiction, both appearance only. And everything is relative to this self-centre. It's judged from there as good or bad, pleasant or painful, happy or sad. We refer to the me, the past memory, things that have happened to us, and we judge it from there. I like it, how do you know? Well, I've had this experience before, it was great. I don't like it, I had it before and I don't like it. So it's relative to that mental image I've got about myself. It's judged from there as good or bad, pleasant, painful, happy, sad. But we point out here that self-centre, that so-called self-centre that's kept us in seeming bondage for so long, is a fiction. It doesn't need to be. looked at or analysed, which you can go on analysing forever. You try to analyse it and work it out in the mind, it'll keep dividing. And you go into one story and another story, and that's to see how this mind duality has been split up. The five factors, 32 tattvas, 100 and so and so's, all trying to put the reality into non-duality. But it can't. It's still non-dual. It's split up by concepts.